بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب زدني علما
And that's not enough. So once you give the network ID, the next step is we need to define the wildcard bits. Okay, so to proceed, we also need to understand. So we understood what is process ID and the significance of the process ID. And then we need to know the wildcard mask or the wildcard bits. Now, this wildcard bits is kind of mandatory in the case of OSPF. So let's try to understand what is this wildcard bits or wildcard mask. Now, same like subnet mask. If I take an example of a subnet mask, so when I'm writing 192.168.2.network 2.0, and when I'm writing the subnet mask, so first let me just define the subnet mask quickly. So when I'm writing 255.255.255.0 means that this is your network portion. So like wherever there is one, that is network, right? Binary ones, of course, decimal, it will be 255. And wherever there is zero, that is zeros, that is your host portion. So the subnet mask will tell how many network portions and how many host portions we have. But the wildcard mask is a little bit different. So the wildcard mask is written in terms of reverse. Like if I'm writing the wildcard mask of 192.168.2.network, and if I write the wildcard mask of 0.0.0.255, means wherever there is zero, that is must match, must compare or must match. Wherever there is one, decimal one means nothing but binary ones. Decimal 255 means binary ones, and in terms of binary it is zeros. So wherever there is one, that has to be ignored. Which means in this example, when I say network 192.168.2.0, and then if I write the wildcard mask of this one 0.0. beside this 0.0.0.255, so what this says is it's going to tell the OSPF that advertise all the addresses whichever having the zero means advertise the address which starts with 192. Second portion also must match 168. Third portion also should match 2. And wherever there is one means binary ones, ignore. Ignore means don't, it can be anything. So any address means X represents any number from 0 to 255. So wherever there is 0, that is must match, and wherever there is 1, that is ignore. So specifically, you want to advertise selected subnets in your production networks. The wildcard mask will help you to match that exact networks. Like if you take this example here, if I'm writing 10.1.2.0, so it means advertise all the addresses whichever starts with 0 means which it must start with 10. Second one 0 means it must start with 1 exact, and this also 0 means it must start with 2, and 255 means ignore. Ignore means it can be anything from 0 to 255. So whatever the address, X means any number it can be. So this first statement says advertise each and every network which has 10 in the first portion, second portion 1, 10, 1, 2. Now, similar way, if you compare some more examples, let's say if I write something like this 0.0.255.255, the meaning of this is it's going to advertise all the addresses whichever starts with 10. 10 means must match 0. 0 means must match again here 1. And 255 means 1, ignore, which means the second and third portion can be anything. But if this router is having any networks and that particular network is matching the first two portions like 10.1, then advertise those interfaces. Now similar way, one more example, if I'm writing this wildcard mask, which means it's going to advertise all the addresses whichever starts with 10, and the remaining three portions can be anything. So 255 means ignore. So 0 says it must check, 1 says ignore. So the same concept you apply in the ACLs, probably in the ACLs topic you will see that generally, but in the ACLs it is to match, permit or deny, but here it is to advertise. Like if you take this example here, 10.1.0.0, the same example, 0.0.255255 means advertise all the addresses whichever starts with 10.1. So basically in most of the advertisements, we want to advertise all the networks, all the addresses, whichever matches the network portion. And that's the reason you have this reverse. So if you want to calculate, you have some examples here. Like here you can see, if you want to calculate the subnet mask of any network, like let's say I'm using 192.168.2. network with a subnet mask of /24, that is 255.255.255.0. Then to calculate the wildcard mask, you just need to subtract from all 255, subtract the subnet mask. So if you subtract 255.255.255.0, you get this wildcard mask. So this is more like writing the inverse mask, or this is how you calculate. Similar way, if you have the subnet mask of 255.255.255.240, this is more like subnet. Again, because in the production scenarios, when we design the networks, so this network will be used like subnets to /28 or some other slash value. Then how can I advertise all the addresses within that range? Simple, find out the subnet mask and write down the subnet mask here and subtract that subnet mask from all 255s to get your wildcard mask. So which means if I want to advertise this subnet, I need to write 192.168.1.0 with a wildcard mask of 0.0.0.15, which is equivalent to matching all the addresses within that range. A similar way, another example, if you have the subnet mask of 255.255.255.0, especially when you're using subnets, and if you want to match all the addresses within that subnet, then subtract that subnet mask from the from all 255s. Generally, we call it as a global subnet mask or all 255s. Again, if you're advertising one single address, then generally we use this one. Like you want to advertise only this address, then we can write 0000 as well. So I got some more examples for you to understand a little bit more better the wildcard mask. So what if I write the wildcard mask of all zeros? Let's say if I'm writing an address 10.0.0.1, and if I write wildcard mask of all zeros means it's going to match all the four portions, right? Zero means must match, which means it will only advertise the address whichever starts with 10.0.0.1, which means it must match all the four portions. So it's going to advertise only one single IP. This is more common when you're advertising the WAN interfaces, especially your point-to-point networks, when you want to advertise only one interface. Because when you're advertising the LAN, we want to advertise all the addresses within that LAN. But when you're advertising point-to-point interfaces, especially the WAN interfaces, in most of the production scenarios, we generally go with this configuration of advertising only one address. Of course, not compulsory, but a kind of best practice you do. So when you're writing 000255 means, if I write 192.168.1.0, 000255 means it's going to advertise all the addresses matching the first three portions. If I'm writing 00 means matching the first two portions. If I'm writing just 0, matching the first portion only. Like in this example, it matches the first two portions. In this example, matches only the first portion. So what if I write the wildcard mask of 255.255.255 means it actually matches all the addresses. Just like matching any address, it doesn't compare any address, but this wildcard mask means it matches all the addresses will be matched with a network command generally. But a little bit we don't use that, but these are the examples to understand, because these are the different kind of examples you see. And of course, whenever you see this kind of wildcard mask means, you need to understand there are specific subnets used in that range.